Now we are going to enter into the discussion session. Please allow me to invite Mr. Evi Haryadi, Mr. Oki Muraza, and Mr. Demetrios Papatanasiou. Please come to the stage. Please give a round of applause to all of our distinguished speakers for today. Thank you very much. Welcome to all the speakers. We are going to have a short presentations from the speakers because of the limited time, unfortunately, that we might only have like 5 to 10 minutes for each speakers. First, I would like to invite Mr. Haryadi. He is the Director of Transmission and System Planning at PLN Persero. He will be sharing PLN leadership in advancing decarbonization efforts in Indonesia towards net zero emissions 2060. Pak Haryadi, you have 10 minutes. The stage is yours.
Thank you, Bu Maya, for giving me time for sharing. Good morning, everybody. Referring what the keynote speech point out, especially regarding the we not just talk, but we must walk the talk about the how we implement the NDC. In this time, PLN, we would like to share to you what we have done until now regarding the NDC achievement, especially for achieving NDC in 2030. Based on our plates, maybe there is a presentation that could be sent.
Operator, could you please?
Okay, still waiting for the presentation. I think based on our background, that our government and also PLN has been signed the Paris pledge that we must achieve around 29% of reducing the emission and enhancing become 31.89. It means around 900 million ton will be achieved for reducing the target. And based on this target, the energy sector must reduce around 358 million ton CO2 equivalent. It means this is the second largest. Now in PLN, based on this target, PLN has a target around 127 million ton. It's including how we develop the renewable energy and how we do the co-firing and also how we implementing the technology, especially for coal that efficient, more efficient. Based on this, we have been planned for RUPTL 2021-2030 that we want to build around 21 gigawatt renewables. Now we reviewing this, and now we plan for the new accelerated renewable energy development that built in the end of 2060 is become 480 gigawatt of renewables, and it costly around 700 billion, and this also including still maintaining around 19 gigawatt coal and gas with a CCUS. And we want to report what we achieve now. Until now, we have achieved around 39 million ton emission reduction through the implementation of this key initiative. We have a key initiative. One is renewable energy development. Now we have commissioned around 1 gigawatt and under construction around 3 gigawatt and still plan and also development is around 17 gigawatt. In the case of the second initiative is biomass co-firing, we have do some co-firing piloting in 43 coal power plant. And also we do some improvement in loss, improvement in grid. We do reducing around 0.9% of the total transmission losses and also the distribution losses. Another is implementing the clean coal technology. In the clean coal technology, we have been implement and operate for another 5 gigawatt of more efficient coal technology. And also for expansion, the CCGT is 0.5 gigawatt of the expansion. In the case of short term and long term targeting, this 5 initiative in the short term, oh lebih dekat ya, okay. Well, because it's a very we will in the short term we will build 21 gigawatt of renewables, and in case of co-firing, now we plan for 52 that now has been achieved around 43 that has been explained before. It's just only 8 or 9% of biomass co-firing. It will be upgrading to 30% in 2060. In the case of energy efficiency, we also have targeting 1.4 that has been achieved around 0.9, and we hope this also increasing in beyond 2030. And another is we also implementing 2.7 gigawatt more efficient coal technology, and now has been achieving. And for 6.7 gigawatt combined cycle is now has been achieved around 2 gigawatt. For the long term one, we want to implementing also the hydrogen co-firing and also CCS and the new technology of maybe nuclear power plant in the future. If we see in the case of implementing the renewables, this is one of example that we make a operation for hydropower Poso Pickers in 2022, and also Ranto Dadap for geothermal, and the last is the floating Cirata that's become the third biggest floating power plant in the world. In the case of co-firing that has been explained before, that we built 43 from 52 the target, is reducing around 1.5 million ton per year, and also need some supporting around 1.5 what we call it is supply. And it could be there is a lot of opportunity that still need to build the feedstock. We think that we need around 8 million ton till 10 million ton in the next 10 years. And we also do regarding the carbon capture that we as you see that we also plan in the future maybe still maintaining around 19 gigawatt coal and gas. In 14 gigawatt coal, we have make some piloting project in three location. One location is in Suralaya, 4.400 megawatt and 3.600 megawatt together with the Korean carbon, and also another location in Indramayu, 3.300 megawatt with the impact, and also Jera in PLN Tanjung Jati B. We hope this pilot project it will be make some experience to us and give us some also knowledge what kind of challenge that will be facing in the future. Another is PLN also the pioneer of establishing a supply chain for hydrogen. Now we have starting scale up the green hydrogen in Indonesia. We have a plan in every power plant that bigger than 100 megawatt. And now we have producing around 200 ton per year. And because of the internal utilization only 75 ton per year, we still have around 122 ton per year that could be used to become another, like hydrogen co-firing or maybe for hydrogen car. And we now starting to implementing this to another utilization. Another that we achieve now is regarding the carbon market. We have built the application. We call it the PLN Climate Click. This application is make a possible. We are do internal transaction, especially between our coal power plant. We have around 55 coal power plant, and we do some transaction between them based on regulation that the same in Applegatrick. Another is we also join the Applegatrick system, that there is the transaction between the PLN power plant, the 55 PLN power plant with the 44 the IPP power plant. This based on mandatory carbon transaction, then based on like a cap in every power plant. And we also has been joined with the carbon market with one of our power plant is a PL2 PLTGU Muara Karang is combined cycle one. And also another we supporting and preparing also including sustainability in our corporate vision and also corporate operation. We have settled ESG policy and also the framework and also ESG performance enhancement. Now we also have achieved some improvement regarding the ESG rating. We have achieved make an improvement from 36 rating to become 30. And maybe in the next year, we will be make it more better and become the medium risk rating. And another, we also have some improvement regarding ESG performance enhancement. We make it a dashboard, also some breakthrough, and also we make a deployment of the target and KPI to all of our unit. And we try also to implement all of the ESG standard in our system based on TCFD, ISO, CDP, and all. That's what we want to say to you, what PLN achieved until now regarding achieving the target of the NDC in 2030. Thank you very much for your...
Thank you very much, Pak Haryadi. Very interesting. You have provided an update on PLN's efforts to decarbonization.